Well, a number of strategies have popped up during the pandemic to keep us safe. One of those, temperature checks. But the question is, how accurate and reliable are they? Our Sydney Stallworth sat down with a doctor to find out.
Temperature checks are a great tool, but they could give us a false sense of security if we don't look for any other symptoms. Dr. Shaw says it's important to know that checking your temperature shouldn't be the only thing you take into consideration if you're worried you have coronavirus.
Yeah, the data is not great on doing temperature checks. I think it's helpful to have so that you can catch the few people that might have a fever and didn't realize they did, but it's only one of 14 symptoms of coronavirus.
Dr. Shaw says lesser known symptoms need to be looked out for as well, and you can keep an eye out for those every day at home.
There's a range. It's fever, cough, shortness of breath are the main ones we look at, but you can have sore throat, body aches, chills, congestion, runny nose, headache, loss of sense of smell or taste, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, or fatigue. So oftentimes somebody doesn't even have fever. They just have nausea and diarrhea and they think they might have the stomach bug when in reality it's coronavirus.
And some symptoms can be even more rare. According to Healthline, dermatologists in Lombardy, Italy monitored 88 people who tested positive for COVID-19. They found roughly 20% actually had skin symptoms like rashes or hives. Dr. Shaw says if you have any of the symptoms she mentioned, even if they're mild, think it's better to be safe than sorry.
If you have symptoms like that, please stay home. If you know that you're going into a place that's going to be checking your temperature, please don't rely just on the temperature check to consider yourself safe.
Wearing a mask and keeping it on securely will help all of us control the spread.
You want to make sure that it's covering your nose and your mouth, and that you might have to speak loudly or enunciate more, but please don't pull it down to speak.
Putting the Valley first, Sydney Stallworth, WZDX News.